Let's be honest, nobody likes printers. They always run out of ink, and the ink itself costs a fortune. I'm bypassing all that today because I've gone to a 3D printing company called Hollywood 3D Printing. Today, they're going to 3D print my face.
We provide 3D printing, 3D design, 3D scanning, and sort of custom fabrication, painting, finishing services for anybody looking to turn an idea into a physical, real piece.
I used to love video games when I was a kid, so to see myself as a 3D character is gonna blow my mind.
A good way to think about 3D printing compared to regular printing is printing multiple layers of that ink on one sheet of paper, but the ink actually is solid and has thickness. So after you stack up multiple layers of the ink, which we just call filament or model material, you actually get a physical three-dimensional piece. The scanner we use is an Artec EVA scanner, and it's a handheld high-resolution optical 3D scanner. So what happens is about 30 seconds or a minute, the device is constantly emitting lights, 30 frames a second, 60 frames a second, flashing a white light. And then from the reflected image, 3D mesh data is gathered frame by frame. So what we end up with is a collection of many, many frames of partial meshes of just one piece of the head at a time, one piece of the shoulders at a time. And as we move around slowly, you'll see frame by frame, you get different parts of the body. And then software in the 3D scanning suite morphs all the data together based on common points. So once we have the finished 3D model file, we load it into a special piece of software called a slicer, and we set the print properties, the layer resolution, and the type of material used. So the slicer takes that information and it literally slices the file up in software, starting from the bottom and going up to the top. So the printer will understand Mike's face as a stack of slices, each 0.01 inches thick, in the pattern of the outline of his head. Once we get the 3D model file finished, the slicer takes about 30 seconds and then it's off to the printer, and the printer takes a couple hours to do the head at a couple inches tall. We're gonna be 3D printing Mike in ABS plastic. That is where, from bottom to top, starting with the bottom of his upper chest area up to the top of the head, layer by layer, kind of like a hot glue gun inverted, going around in a specific pattern layer by layer in ABS plastic. So it's a melted plastic that, as soon as it comes out of the hot nozzle, a stream of hot air cools it instantly.
Here we have the finished 3D printed part. It is in red plastic, red ABS plastic, but it's covered in this white support material, which acts as sort of a scaffolding during the print process. So I'm just gonna go ahead and crack it and remove it from the print. There we go. There he is, in all his glory.
All right, here we go. Oh my God, what? That looks exactly like me. That's amazing. The jaw structure, the nose, there's a bit of a beard. It almost looks like I've got an afro. This is so cool. Oh my God, a miniature. My ears are so detailed. Wow. It almost looks like it's made of licorice. This is amazing. This is the future of technology. I'm excited to see where this technology goes. If they can make a 3D version of me, there's no telling what they could make a 3D model of next. Oh my God, my nose. Oh my God, touching myself, touching my nose.